spread my arms like frosting, like a phoenix wing around its offspring. Soda pop, sing songs of optimism. 1972, caught the rhythm of a heartbeat, lost the change in a car seat.
From Southeast Texas, we welcome you inside Minute Maid Park here in downtown Houston. It's the home opener of this new season between the Cleveland Indians and the Houston Astros. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Striding in is Cesar Hernandez. He will lead this
leading
one off
the
today.
Afternoon for Cleveland. The second baseman, Cesar.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. And the first pitch of the afternoon misses for ball one. And that's how we get things underway here in the Space City. And now this misses as well, as he's behind the leadoff man this afternoon. 2-0 now. Our temperature, not quite as hot as we'd expected. 85 degrees, the reading at first pitch. The 2-1 home. And a little off to begin the afternoon, as it's to 3-1 now.
He's only four pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
And that misses for ball four, so it's a five-pitch walk to get us started here this afternoon.
The third baseman.
So now into the box is Jose Ramirez. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. A bouncer up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
Batting third, the left fielder, number nine.
Into the box, Eddie Rosario. This will go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Tucker waits on it. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. So first and third with one away. And digging in now, Franmil Reyes. From the stretch. Hit hard up the middle, and there's a base hit, and the Tribe are going to strike first in this one. It's 1-0.
The first baseman
at the plate, Bobby Bradley.
Bobby,
as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one.
Tough situation early out on the mound, but if he can limit the damage right here, might build some confidence and get him rolling.
One ball, one strike to count. Here's the 1-1.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
And he missed again, high and away this time, 3-1.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
There's the good fastball, and he can't catch up. 3-2. And the payoff pitch. Boy, really making him work now, as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. The next 3-2. Now a swing and a deep drive to right. Tucker looks up, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Now that brings up Josh Naylor.
The right fielder.
As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one.
He definitely doesn't look himself to start this one. And this lineup needs to be on the attack early and be aggressive and find a way to stay in this game.
And that's the second out. So now to the plate, Andrés Giménez.
The shortstop.
First delivery to him.
Giménez.
Behind 0-2 now. And another foul ball. A bouncer to the left side. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first. Will finally retire him as the inning will draw to a close. Here comes the second baseman, Jose Altuve, to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one. Here's the first pitch to him. He'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit. A ball and a strike to Houston's leadoff batter.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Loud contact there, but it's well foul. Fouled away. The next 1-2 pitch. Struck him out. Next up is Michael Brantley.
Batting second, the left fielder, Michael.
First pitch of the AB on its way. High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Zimmer. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Stepping up is Carlos Correa. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Now here's the pitch. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's a blooper out toward left center. Jimenez ranging into the outfield. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Striding in for the Indians, Bradley Zimmer. He'll get us started in the top of the second. And he gets the inning started with a bang as this is hit high and deep to left field. Gone as it's into the Crawford boxes.
Batting none.
Stepping in now, Roberto Perez. And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out. Nothing in one. And that misses 1-1.
Well, I'll tell you, if he wants to turn things around, that pitch is one he's going to have to start locating a lot better.
A 1-2 count to the Indians catcher. Still a ball and two strikes. Another 1-2 delivery. Left side. Scooped up. On to first. So a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out.
Now
next to hit, Cesar Hernandez. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. And he fouls this one off. Bases are empty. One man out. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. 2-1 now to the Tribe's leadoff man.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
Altuve has a play, and he makes the catch for the second out. Now to bat, Jose Ramirez. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Swing and a miss at a first pitch changeup. Nothing in one.
Stuff has never been a problem with this pitcher. It's execution and location that has always been his bugaboo. And that's exactly what happened here. I know he's ahead 0-1, but he's finding the heart of the plate way too often.
Hanging curveball taken, though, for a second strike. Hit hard back up the middle. He's got it. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job.
He takes it to the opposite field, high and deep to left. Into the Crawford boxes and gone.
batting fifth.
So here's Yuli Gurriel.
First baseman, Yulievski.
Fouled off.
Gurriel.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Hit on the ground toward the left. Ramirez showing off his range. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning.
Batting sixth.
Next to dig in, Kyle Tucker. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Plesac is a guy who throws a lot of strikes, rarely walks people, but what does bite him occasionally is the home run ball.
Matt, this is a guy that's not a power type of pitcher, so he needs to rely on being down in the strike zone. One of the keys, he tends to lose being aggressive when he falls behind, and he kind of nibbles around the strike zone. And what happens with that, Matty V, he becomes very predictable, and when you don't have overpowering stuff, you tend to be able to get hit hard.
And he'll stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. Next, here is Alex Bregman. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second.
Bregman.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Fouled away.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
Batting it. The catcher.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. And he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one. Runner in scoring position with two gone. And it's quickly 0-2.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to give in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open, so he has to focus on making a good pitch right here.
Jimenez into shallow center. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Now to the plate, here is Eddie Rosario, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Eddie.
Here it comes.
Rosario.
First pitch is a changeup for a called strike.
Hey, let's not sugarcoat it. He's had a rough couple innings. He's going to have to find a way, whether it be mechanic.
Meanwhile, now, this is a drive out to straightaway right field, and it's going to get out of here. A home run. And that'll bring in Fran Reyes.
The designated hitter.
As he rips it on the ground to second. Throw on to first in time, one away. Digging in will be Bobby Bradley. And we'll see what he can do here after going deep his first time up.
Well, you don't see this very often, Matty V. A two-strike straight changeup. But this guy changeup is one of the best in the league. We'll see if he tries that different approach this time. And maybe if he gets to two strikes, try to use the fastball a little bit more than that straight changeup.
The 1-1 home misses off the plate. All even now, 2-2. And it's fouled away. Now another 2-2. High in the air out to center field. Strong is there now, and he has it. Two gone. So next to hit is Josh Naylor.
The right fielder.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. And he fouls this one off. 50th pitch of the game on its way. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Lifted down the line in left, but this will wind up being a foul ball. Two out, nobody on. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Tucker gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Miles Straw, and they could use a spark from him here.
The center fielder, number 7.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Zimmer has it, and it's a quick out number 1. And now in the box, Jose Altuve struck out in his first at bat.
Altuve.
Pitch on the way. 1 out, nobody on. And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in 2 count, and the pitch. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, 2 away. Here's Michael Brantley, flied out on his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
Brantley.
And here's a fastball called for strike 1.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
And this one scoots all the way to the wall. And he'll make it to second base now with 2 gone.
The batter, number 1.
So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball 1. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Has a look, now the pitch. And nothing will come of the 2-out double as the inning is over. New inning set to get underway. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Andrés Giménez.
Andrés.
Drilled on the ground to short. Reined in. Throw to first in time. 1 gone here in the 4th. In now for Cleveland, Bradley Zimmer off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at bat, so there's got to be a good chance they mix it up right here on him and try and go off speed.
Curveball down and in, misses, ball 2.
I wonder if that homer rattled him a little bit. He's certainly a little bit more cautious against him this time around.
Toward the gap in right center, this is going to be a base hit, and he may take that big turn at first. And he'll reach second now with 1 away.
Now batting, the catcher, Roberto Perez.
To the plate now, Roberto Perez. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball 1. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0.
And this is why he's struggling right here. He's not able to pound the strike zone early in the count. These guys are finding themselves in serious count leverage situations, and good hitters aren't going to miss.
He's ready now, the pitch. And he popped him up. Altuve is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are 2 away. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Cesar Hernandez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. From the stretch, hit back up the middle. And that's through into center field, base hit. The run scores from second. It's now 7-1.
Now back. First baseman. Jose.
In now, Jose Ramirez, as he'll come up empty there as he misses the off-speed pitch for strike one. A hit and two tries for him so far. Hard on the ground towards short, scooped up onto Altuve for the force out, and the inning is over. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one.
Well, Batty, we know he's got the timing on the fastball locked in. That's what he got a hold of on that home run in the previous at bat. You do not come off the heater. Have to be leery of the off speed, but stay on the fastball. He's got to throw it again.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Now that
next up for the Astros, Yuli Gurriel grounded out in his last at bat.
Gurriel.
Liner in there for a base hit.
The right fielder, number 30.
At the plate now, Kyle Tucker. And that one yanked just foul. Again, another foul ball. From the belt, the pitch sent on the ground out to second. And that's through for a base hit, making 1 for 2 in this one. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
The bat.
And that'll bring up Alex Bregman.
Alex.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. Chasing after it is Rosario. He gets there, and that's the second out. Stepping in once again is now Jason Castro. Two men on, two away here in the fourth.
Castro.
Now the first pitch. Good breaking ball there. Had him frozen. Strike one. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
Hey, down in the count 0-2, I'd like to see a little choke and poke right here. Maybe work it up the middle or opposite field with two strikes.
Gurriel on second, Tucker at first, two out in the inning. Hit out towards second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. The throw to the plate. And not in time as the run scores. And the runner scores from second as they chip into the deficit here. Into the box now, Miles Straw. He swings and grounds it to short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. All set for the start of the inning, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Eddie Rosario. Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch. Oh, forget about this one. Bob, Bob, Booey. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run.
Now back. The designated
now
hitter.
Time is called, and this might be to buy a little time for that reliever to get loose. Enoli Paredes gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. Good slider there, gets a swing and miss. 1 for 2 in the ball game thus far. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
It's a great job to lay off on that nasty slider right there. It's the toughest pitch. It was my toughest pitch to lay off of. I was always sitting fastball middle away, and when that slider came out, boy, did it look like a heater for a long time.
Fouled off. Full count, 3-2 to the Indians DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Pitch on the way.
Bobby
Bradley comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. Fouled away. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And he strikes him out as well. So two punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen.
Now batting. Right,
so the bases are empty with two gone now. And the next to bat will be Josh Naylor, who started him with the change, and it's nothing in one.
Great execution of that changeup right there. Great arm action. Batter was totally out front on that one.
They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Onto the first baseman Gurriel, and that will end the inning. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jose Altuve. No hits to this point.
The second baseman.
Now the first pitch.
Altuve.
Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
But this will be taken in out there at short, and that's the first out of the inning.
Left fielder, number 23.
Now into the box, Michael Brantley. He doubled his last time through. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Now batting, shortstop, Carlos Correa.
Here's Carlos Correa now, as he'll take a look at his strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. And it's fouled away. Brantley leads off second with one gone in the inning. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Line toward right center, and that gets down as he can't get there in time. The runner from second scores as they inch a bit closer, and he'll scramble back to first safely.
The batter, number 44.
Standing in now, Yordan Alvarez. As he'll go after a curveball out of the zone to start the at-bat, it's 0-1. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Good pitch there down below the zone, got him to go after it. Ready with the 0-2. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
The first baseman, number 10.
Runner at first with two gone in the inning. And digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Lofted in the air out toward right center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Andres Jimenez the next to bat.
Leading off for the Indians, the shortstop, Andres Jimenez.
First pitch of the AB now. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Brantley is under it, makes the play, one away. Ready now is Bradley Zimmer. Already a home run and a double for him in this one. Now a half swing here as he wanted to pull it back, but he does so too late. It's strike one. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. And the pitch. And a curveball here. Good pitch, but a better take, and it's to 2-1 now. Swung on but fouled off to the left.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
So he'll add one to his total as that falls in. He's got three hits in this one.
The catcher, number 55.
Into the box, Roberto Perez. As he'll send a ground ball down to third. Altuve for one. Over to Gurriel for an inning-ending double play. bottom of the sixth inning now, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker.
The right fielder, Kyle.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Chasing after it is Rosario. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. One away for the Astros here in the sixth. And that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. And that's inside for a ball. 1-0.
Hey, every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
Counts even 1-1 to Alex Bregman. Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Jimenez ranging into the outfield. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Now it'll be Jason Castro. A fly out and a single for him so far. First pitch coming. Here it is. Three runs, eight hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Strike taken. Good bender on the outside there.
There seem to be different philosophies on it. So, Dan, what was your approach in 0-2 counts?
My philosophy is this. I think the last thing you want to do is throw non-competitive pitches.
We'll have to leave it there as the play is made for the third out. And stepping in, Cesar Hernandez. One for two on his line so far in the game.
Cesar.
Here's the first pitch to him. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jose Ramirez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Starts him out with a curveball high, 1-0.
Really high curveball right there. Struggling with the release point. That's the key to the curveball, figuring out and finding that release point.
Ball and no strikes. The count to Jose Ramirez. Eight runs, nine hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. Nope. 3-0. Eddie Rosario waits on deck. And boy, that is nowhere near the strike zone as it's all the way to the backstop and a four-pitch walk. Next, it'll be Eddie Rosario. So far, 2-for-3 in this one.
And that home run he hit his last time up, he isn't going to forget about anytime soon. He absolutely destroyed a fastball.
Out in front of it, strike one. Nothing in one count. Here it comes.
Tough to lay off a breaking ball that good, but he saw it all the way.
And he lays off this one down and in for ball two.
And when you're already down five, the last thing you want to do is fall behind in the count when you're on the mound. That's not going to do anything to help you get back into this thing.
But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
The batter.
Striding forward now is the DH, Franmil Reyes. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front. Hits this one hard the other way. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
The first baseman, number 44, Bobby.
Stepping in now, Bobby Bradley, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. 1-0 pitch is a curveball. That looked good from here, but it's 2-0.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down and away or flip something off speed for a strike.
Now it's driven the other way with some authority, headed toward the foul pole. And this one is gone, a home run. At the plate, Josh Naylor.
Right fielder, Josh.
To right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back to back home runs.
So now to the plate, Andrés Giménez. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Up around the letters with that one for ball two. Now the 2-0 home. He swings and crushes it. Oh my, there is no doubt about this one. And they've done it again. Back to back to back home runs. And that'll bring in the San Diego product, Bradley Zimmer. As he'll swing and lift a fly ball to right center. Tucker is there to put it away and finally put an end to the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And standing in the outfielder, Miles Straw.
The center fielder. Number 7.
Joe Maton gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 88.
Now the first pitch. Right through it here, and he's behind 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in control 0-2. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Jose Altuve. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. No balls and one strike. Comes set with the 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
The relay, not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Up next to the Astros, the left fielder.
And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. Line to the right side, and that's through into right field for a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Now batting, shortstop.
To the plate now, Carlos Correa. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Waiting on it is Zimmer. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And he will score on the sacrifice fly. And the runner from third crosses the plate. Next will be the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez.
44.
Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. Strike one to start the at-bat.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Swing and a line drive. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Roberto Perez.
The catcher, number 55, Roberto.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one. As we head toward a conclusion in this one, I think it's fair to say that it's going to be a long time before you see a team perform like this again at the plate.
Yeah, the ability of this lineup to hit that many home runs, I mean, strewn throughout the line, it screams to the modern day of baseball. The three true outcomes, these guys aren't worried about hitting singles. They're trying to stop traffic over that fence.
D-Roy, it can't be better said. I think the day and age right now for pitchers is you have to approach just about every pitch like it's a two-strike pitch. No get-me-over curveballs, no get-me-over changeups. Every pitch has to be thrown with a purpose.
Up next for Cleveland. The second base.
So here is Cesar Hernandez. Flew out last time up. Now here's the first offering.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes. What are you supposed to do other than keep trying new guys until someone starts attacking the zone?
And it's 1-2. Perez on at first. Nobody out. Hit back toward the mound. And that's through for a hit.
Now third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
At the plate now, Jose Ramirez. And now a curveball as he's got to lean out of the way. That one nearly got him. Pedro Baez comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one.
Pedro Baez.
The 1-0. Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes now.
Wow, that changeup is an absolute beaut. They call it the great equalizer for a reason.
That's lifted the other way out to left. Brantley is under it. One down. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. And now, Eddie Rosario has got two hits in four at-bats. First pitch on the way. This is pulled into right. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away.
Designated hitter from the
in now, Franmil Reyes, as he'll cut on and miss it. A good slider at the knees for strike one. Two hits in four attempts to this point. Hit down the third baseline. Boy, and the shellacking continues as this is down for extra bases. One run is scored. And they'll hold that runner at third, so everyone moves up and they remain loaded here with still only one gone.
Bobby.
Into the box, Bobby Bradley. As a good changeup will get him to commit too early, and it's strike one. Two home runs already to his name in this one, and we'll see if he could possibly strike again. And he lays off for ball one.
It's moments like this as a pitcher when you feel the whole world is against you. You're already in hot water with the bases loaded, so it doesn't make life any easier when you're not getting calls that you think you should.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now at the plate, Josh Naylor. He's got one hit in four at-bats.
Yeah, Matt, going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
Behind 0-2 now. Looking to leave him loaded. And it's belted high and deep into right center. Boy, and call off the dogs already as this is down for extra bases. And the second runner's going to hold over at third, so a run scores and they remain loaded here with two away.
Andres.
Into the box now. Andres Jimenez. Fly ball right down the line and left. Brantley is there and he puts it away as they're able to escape with only limited damage on the scoreboard. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and here comes the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. From the stretch, here's the pitch, and he fouls this one off. Nothing in one count, here it comes. A ball hit softly on a line to third, and a knock for him this time. He's 2-for-4 for the game.
The right fielder, number 30.
So now to the plate, Kyle Tucker, as he rips it on the ground to second. And that's in for a base hit. He's 2-for-4 now. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Third baseman, number 2, Allen.
And that'll bring up the former first-rounder Alex Bregman. No balls and a strike to count. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Gurriel at second. Tucker on at first with nobody out. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
The catcher.
Here's the first pitch.
Castro.
Line towards center field. And that's in there. Base hit. Gurriel rounds third and is digging for the plate. And this will not be in time as he's into third base safely.
Number seven.
At the plate, Miles Straw. Grounder down the line at third. This gets foul. It's 0-1. And he powers a cut fastball by him that time, and he's in charge now, nothing and two. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. Hernandez at second. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired.
Wow, what a week for these guys. Talk about firing on all cylinders. Winners of an amazing seven games in a row. They say to never question the streak, and these guys aren't. They're just enjoying this ride.
15-5 is the final. The Cleveland Indians jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back.